fucking switches back here.
Don't swear when little Will is here.
He isn't here. He's eating Cheetos in the Subaru.
No, I'm here.
Keep your Cheetos out of my Subaru, boy.
Guys, I'm a teenager, okay? I'm old enough to know that snacking in the soup makes Dad's hair plugs ache.
My plugs can react to stress and when it's going to rain.
You have a superpower. We get it. Jesus.
No swearing.
Where's the switch, hon?
It's behind the curtain.
I asked your mother.
Whatever. I'm gonna go play a video game for a sec.
No, it's almost showtime.
Ugh, fine. I guess I'll go coil some stage rope or something, since there's nothing else to do in this theater.
You kids and your video games. A spoiled generation. I used to coil rope all the time as a hobby when I was your age. I appreciated nature.
Calm down, Will. It was the 70s. My hair was 2 feet tall. That took modern technology. Okay, the switch is by the curtain somewhere. I'm groping the wall now.
Mom, please do not say groping.
Am I supposed to say another word?
Yes.
Fine, I'm caressing with obvious intention.
Everything's terrible!
I found the switch!
That's my hot huntress.
Oh, Will, stop.
I can't. I'm incorrigible. Just call me Han Solo with a couple of emergency depends in my pocket, because you never know.
You scoundrel.
I'm more confused than disgusted.
When will you start to realize that your parents still being together after 17 years is a good thing?
Yeah, your father and I are the Mission Impossible franchise of relationships. It's not great, but it is still happening.
Oh, yeah, I love you.
The screen is already down.
Why aren't they applauding? Go get the applause sign.
I don't want to get the applause sign, Dad.
Go!
Ugh.
Little Will scampers out from backstage, trying not to be seen. Lights up on the stage. Little Will picks up an applause sign from the front of the stage. Applaud from the audience.
Hello and welcome to the performance of our play, The Incident of the Robbery at the Gas Station on Fairfax and Waring. A play by the Bilford family. What can I say? I like my titles how I like my conversations with my grandmother. Too long and not interesting.
As you probably guessed,
we're the Bilfords!
And boy, do we have a story for you.
A story so good, it was being developed as a screenplay.
Actually, not just a screenplay, but a big Hollywood screenplay by Martin Scorsese's nephew, Taxi Driver.
If only my sister named her son after my most popular work, Penis Graffiti in a Chili's Bathroom.
Oh my God, that was so embarrassing.
But the deal for the big Hollywood screenplay fell through.
Just like Jean Dujardin, our time in a Hollywood spotlight was short, but sweet.
You're probably wondering who Jean Dujardin is.
He's the 2011 Best Actor winner for The Artist. I thought theater audiences were supposed to be cultured. What are you, orphans in a book for children?
Trudy, what did we say about calling the audience orphans from a book for children when you think they're stupid?
I'll do it, but just for the story.
No, no, that's what we say in case we run into Elton John at a rodeo and he offers us cocaine.
Don't do it.
Nice.
You guys, can we just get this over with?
Oh, looks like someone didn't have their morning coffee.
I don't drink coffee. I'm a teenager. I wake up by watching the same parody video 18 times in a row.
Just get that.
I will after I tell Junior how we didn't have parody videos during the war. We survived on coffee and strength alone.
Can you stop talking about the war for like 1 second?
Oh, the war is what he calls that time when the toilet was clogged for 3 days.
Just because I wasn't born yet doesn't mean I don't understand the struggle.
I plunged until I couldn't see. My retinas were weakened. Your generation will never understand that. Why else do you think I wear glasses when I read?
Oh, for God's sake, this play isn't about clogged toilets, but our greatest family-wide achievement.
Indeed. We are the Bilfords from the very famous and well-yelped Bilford and Family Private Detective Agency. The only family-owned PI agency in Los Angeles. I'm Will Bilford, PI. I'm the head of a family of private detectives. Like the Von Trapps if they got banned from Walmart. You know when you hear about people who get banned from Walmart? Just close your eyes and picture them now. You see us, don't you? You know those people who argue in the cheese aisle about who has to tell their kid that their dog is dead?
I'm Trudy Bilford, PI. But even more importantly, I'm Trudy Bilford, devoted wife and mother.
You have hazed me before.
Just enough to make you funny when you're older.
I'm funny now. I do surprise trust falls all the time.
That's not funny, sweetheart. Please. Do your intro.
I'm little Will Bilford, child PI. I'm their kid.
And together, we are
the Bilford Family Detectives.
We've been in business for 16 years. Here's a picture of our office. Though we recently moved.
We call it the new office, but the neighbors call it what that place with the world record for asbestos. We got it for a good price.
Shh, they have to think that we're rich. We can't give the fact away that this is a rise and fall story just yet. It's supposed to be a whole play, like a real full story with 60 to 120 pages.
We can't do that.
Yes, we can. Never mind. My son has ruined the plot of the play, just as he has ruined my nipples after breastfeeding.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is indeed a tragedy. Just like when you're at a party and you want to go home, but the person you came with is like, I want to stay for 30 more minutes, and then you're like, but I'm tired.
Oh, it's not just like that. Well, we might as well tell you the rest of it, right? Let's keep this going so it'll be over sooner.
Good initiative, Junior. When you act like that, I love you. No. Let's prepare ourselves for Act 1, Scene 1.
The office.
Our story begins with Will Bilford, PI, sitting alone in his office. But really, he's sitting alone in a dream.
Oh, good line, honey.
Trudy, I'm monologuing. That's when she walked in. A real hell of a broad. Her legs were like... Oh, okay, sorry. This is where I have to explain something. No one would audition for the part of the mysterious woman. Literally no actress even kinda wanted the part. Which is saying a lot, because we live in L.A. That means that people audition for Daddy's Home too, but they drew the line in this play.
So instead of an actress, we got this mannequin from our sponsor, Overstock.com, the greatest website for all your bargain needs. Mm.
Trudy did the voiceover because she's brilliant.
You could say I was born to mumble things to myself in a soundproof box.
And the drama teacher at Little Will's High School is giving his students extra credit for being the puppeteer for Mysterious Woman once a week. It is my pleasure to introduce tonight's puppeteer from Van Nuys High School, Derek Dirtberg.
Theater can change people, Little Will. Have some faith. Maybe he'll become a sensitive boy after this.
Derek, do you want to introduce yourself?
Derek is a backflip.
How's that for you to introduce yourself? 4 out of 10. Give us something to work with here, Derek. A fun fact, maybe one of your hobbies.
Derek takes a lamp from a desk. He starts rubbing it against the table.
See? It's like the lamp is dry porking the desk.
He drops the lamp and gets the mannequin from backstage.
He has an interest in performance art! Delightful.
Are you serious? How does he think he can behave this way? He isn't even a football douchebag. He just does track and field. It isn't even a sport. It's just a bunch of little sports that happen at once on the same field, so it'll actually get an audience.
You better watch yourself before I pole vault over there and shot puts you in your place.
It's a pun. I love it. Fuck you.
Hold on now, Derek. You can't bully my son while I'm standing right here.
You're right. I'm sorry, sir. I know exactly how far away from me you are in meters, little bitch.
Much better. Give our mannequin puppeteer a hand.
Of course, he stops the show, we'll plug him.
It's just once a week, dear, he'll be gone tomorrow.
Derek snaps the mannequin onto his black robe suit. She stays stuck with him.
Hoorah! So, as I was saying, one hell of a broad. Set the mood, Trudy.
Oh, our hero sits, ripping a cig.
Her legs were like real human legs that moved like legs. Because she was a real, alive human woman.
Derek walked into the office. The manager had been with him as he walks. Anytime Derek has the mannequin Velcro to him, he'll be referred to as DM in the stage directions, which I am reading now. Derek should not be mentally invested in what's happening on stage. He's doing the movements and committing, but in his mind he's smashing a beer can with his skull elsewhere.
I need help!
Well, you came to the right place. I have been described as pretty helpful.
He's also been described as Danny DeVito without eyebrows, in the sense that you think about it and you're like, it's not bad, but it makes me uncomfortable.
My husband's gas station, the one on Fairfax and Waring, was robbed!
I don't normally do robberies. I'm a private detective. I mostly just eat sandwiches in alleyways.
The police don't have enough evidence to catch the rascal who stole our hostess' products. And I know what you're going to say. What's 675? What's a few Twinkies when we're all just meeting the specks of dust?
Actually, I was going to say, is that beef smell me or you?
I'm serious!
So am I! I've been trying to find out where the stench of beef has been coming from for months!
My husband needs this case to be solved. He just hasn't been the same since he had a gun pointed at him. He's been watching Dancing with the Stars and actually calling in to vote for his favorite. It's the saddest thing I've ever seen. Trudy enters. She dressed like a Carmen Sandiego detective.
My beautiful wife, Trudy, enters. She's dressed as if she were two kids in a trench coat trying to sneak into a strip club.
I was thinking Humphrey Bogart if he embraced his slutty side.
I can't think of a more attractive way to describe an outfit than what you just said.
What's this?
This is a customer. Unfortunately, one that we can't accept.
Why not? We have so much wealth.
She makes it rain with Monopoly money, but it's really stiff.
But we could always make more. We're like MySpace in 2003.
That's true, but I'm far too busy spending my riches on hats with feathers stuck in the side and saying words like charcuterie board.
Oh, please, save my husband!
Come on, Will. This poor woman needs help, and we're the only ones who are heroic enough to do it.
I'll pay you generously. I'll give you a year's supply of our signature gas station egg sandwiches, served lukewarm and with E. coli sauce.
Little Will enters.
I've been so distant lately due to my hormone volcano. Solving a case as a family would be a great way to bring us closer, which is my number one priority as a teenager.
I didn't say that. I didn't write the scene, Dad did.
Just act the damn thing, boy. We'll do your scene when it's your turn, but now it's mine.
Ugh! I hate so much. I didn't ask to be a child detective. I just want to eat chips. Alone.
Junior! Don't make me count to three.
Just watch, I'll spend all my allowance on hard drugs.
One.
No, stay strong and I don't care what you do.
Two.
Please, Papa, take the case.
I will.
You're probably wondering how such a delicate flower...
Such as myself.
Okay, could marry into such a dangerous line of work. Well, as every Batman has his begins, as every Robert Downey Jr. has his first line of coke off the areola of a stripper, I too have an origin story for how I was seduced by crime.
Me too.
Me too.
I'm drunk as fuck.
I was born in Missouri.
You were born in Santa Monica.
I was born in Missouri. My mother was an alligator and my father was an alcoholic. My younger sister was always the pretty one. Even when our house burned down, Pappy never approved of my love with our swamp neighborhood's bad boy, Will Bilford. He was like a gorilla when it came to his personality and also skin texture.
Will rip his shirt off, it's not sexy.
Trudy! Oh, Trudy, come back to me! I don't have any more shirts to rip, Trudy!
I listen to my Pappy. I had one choice, work my way out of Missouri. I became a businesswoman. That's right, I worked my way to the top and I stayed there, baby. I had sales for breakfast, a martini for lunch, and vertical integration for dinner. I was all like, yes, see you at the meeting. No, and don't
don't forget to tell Elliot that I'll give him a dog and then kidnap that dog as soon as he's bonded with it if he doesn't get my business reports. That's when Will and I decided to get married. I was finally ready to become someone's partner.
Where was I before she proposed? Well, after Trudy rejected me, I decided to try my luck out west while working in a sardine cannery.
Oh, to this day, instead of sweating, he just leaks that oil that's in cans of fish.
Every day was the same. You put the fish in the can, you put the fish in the can, you approve a can that doesn't have any fish in it, just your co-workers' severed fingers. Because it was a different time. The jungle had only been out for 90 years. But I was missing something. I was missing Trudy. Then she called.
We had a destination wedding because we wanted to make an extra special fuck you to our families.
It was a beautiful wedding, but it wasn't as beautiful as the bride.
The bride is what we called the kilos of cocaine that we were going to smuggle back into the U.S.
You gotta pay for the honeymoon somehow.
That's when our little girl was conceived.
Ew, can you guys leave me out of this?
Well, why don't you do your backstory then if ours isn't good enough?
Why don't I just go home? You know, Jason is having a party tonight, and I really want to go.
We'll talk about it after the play.
But I could have done, like, 3 rounds of Dance Dance Revolution by then.
Come on, little Will. Speaking in front of an audience will give you a much-needed confidence boost.
No, thank you. I like my confidence where it is, dead on a highway.
Do it. And we'll talk about the party later.
Hi, I'm little Will. I'm a teenager.
Give the audience new information.
You're doing great, sweetie.
You're a virgin who sucks at backstory.
Okay. Well, the day I was born, my dad mistook a meatball sandwich for me.
You'd be surprised how much newborn babies resemble meatball sandwiches.
Anyway, he picked up the sandwich and said, "I don't know if I will ever love anything as much as I love you." And then I said, "Well, they're cutting the cord right now, he's over here." I feel like that was a pretty good introduction to what my life would be like.
It's true, though. I never loved anything as much as I loved you. Until a year later.
That's right.
Because a year later is when we opened Bilford & Family Private Detective Agency. Hey, spotlight over here.
I thought it was my turn.
They're here for the family story. If they wanted the story of an angry teen, they would just read Harry Potter fanfiction.
I don't care about talking, it's just that he literally stole the spotlight again.
I knew I had a knack for sleuthing ever since 10th grade PE. The other boys hid my jeans while I was showering, but I found them almost right away.
He walked out of the gym fully naked, even though they only took his pants.
I followed clues until I found my pants in a nearby tree. But more importantly, I found my detectiviness.
We wanted to start a business together, a legacy that we could pass on to little Will.
I knew that my dream was to be happy with my work and spend a lot of time with my family. Then I thought, let's combine it and make a small business where you use your greatest skill, detectiving.
Yeah, right.
We all have our special skills. Trudy, my dear wife, always thinks outside the box.
I'm a wild card.
Junior here can sniff out any perk.
I'm good at tracking.
Like a dog.
He loves to say that.
And I, well, to be honest, I have many special talents.
Yes, baby, love yourself.
But my greatest skill of all is leadership. Together we make a great team.
How could we not? We're the Bilfords.
I remember our first crime like it was yesterday. Because at the time, I was taking enough cop syrup every day to kill 8 horses. It sharpens the experience.
The case of the heiress with the dead aunt and mother. Unforgettable.
Who would have thought it was the professor in the opium den with the ABBA-inspired vision board the whole time?
You did.
It's true, I did. After my success with that case and the media attention for how we solved it as a family, our little agency thrived.
The Bilfords line up and put their right hands over their hearts. Gazing in the lights above, America the Beautiful begins to play.
My family became the epitome of the American dream. We were saving Americans every day.
We were giving them photographic evidence of their husbands fucking their nannies.
We were confirming who was gay and who was communist in important government families.
All of it's true. My mom hired him to find out if my dad was really John Malkovich or just some bald man in a public bathroom. It was both! I'm John Malkovich's bastard son, everybody!
What could be more American dreamy than that?
Which brings us back to the greatest mystery we ever solved, the climax of our business saga.
The one we started earlier, before the backstories, the one with the mysterious woman. We promise you a show, not structure.
Now we shall jump back into that storyline seamlessly.
To the gas station on Fairfax and Waring!
The building
here. Transition.
I'm so glad you're here to help me save my husband, the gas station owner.
Anything for a citizen.
We live to save the greater good.
And now, we must introduce our next performer. Starring as the gas station owner, esteemed character actor William H. Macy! Mr. H. Macy and I love to joke about how tardy he is. Let's try one more time. Mr. William H. Macy!
Again, nothing.
Where is he?
Well, honey, he never really showed up in the first place.
What?
We just commented that he should come on a Facebook photo that Jan posted.
He seemed so down to earth. I thought he would come.
I'm sorry, my friend.
Oh, I guess we can't finish the show now. No, we just can't do it without the gas station owner. I'll just be going to Jason's house.
No. What do we say when we fall off the horse, little Will?
I don't...
The show must go on.
Why can't we just be normal and give up on everything easily?
I'm sorry to say, my dear, but little Will has a point. We need another actor. None of us can play two characters. We're too important to the narrative.
No, darling, but I've never quit in anything in my entire life, and I won't quit now.
I'll do it!
Who said that?
Me, Priscilla, the lady janitor.
Oh, of course, the lady janitor. Audience, this is the theater's trash mistress.
Well, I am toilet princess, but yeah.
Priscilla, you should just enjoy the show. The shoes of William H. Macy are notoriously hard to fill.
Please, your show has been such a joy to watch these last 4 days.
That's right, people. 4 days, four shows down there.
I have to act, so like, yeah. You're kind of ruining this for me.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
My best friend is a mop. He's got a bucket, but it's like really complicated.
Come on, Will! Be the feminist hero I always knew you could be.
I am known first and foremost as a feminist hero. Fine, I will let Priscilla play the gas station owner.
Music cut.
We'll skip bop-a-doo, beep, skip bop-a-doo. I'm so excited to not be poo.
What a nice little song.
Thank you, janitors love to rhyme. Welcome to my gas station. Disclaimer, you might have everything taken from you while you're here, including your life.
Bilford detectives, this is my husband, the gas station owner.
Pleased to meet you.
A little birdie told me you had a few Twinkies taken from you.
Yes, the robbery. I don't see why you care. The police sure didn't.
Well, I'm not the police.
Or he should say, we're not the police.
That's right, we're the Bilford Family Private Detectives. We're here to find the person who robbed you of your manhood and put them behind bars.
That's not necessary. Besides, I have an episode of American Idol to watch with my mouth open.
No! They're here to help. Let them.
Fine. Take a look around.
Excellent. We will begin. All right, little Will. Track him.
Little Will starts circling around, looking at the ground. The ground is warmer here.
Oh, incredible! That's where the robber was standing when he pointed the gun at me.
Little Will wanders a bit more and then points to the air.
And the Twinkies he stole were taken from this shelf full of Hostess products? How did he know? He's superhuman.
Please, ma'am, I'm just your average neighborhood child detective.
Oh, I have an idea.
My dearest, please tell us.
Let's watch the security tape. Maybe we will find
a clue!
Little Will and Trudy began running back and forth like before.
Transition.
We are now in the gas station office.
Transition. The Bilfords line up in front of the screen, facing it. Priscilla, stand on opposite
tape begins to play, revealing that it's not actually the security tape, but a shitty crime reenactment thing that Milford's made. It shows the fault. Little Will enters with a fake gun, wearing sunglasses and a hat.
Put your hands up!
No, please! I'm emotionally fragile!
Little Will grabs a fistful of Twinkies.
I'm gonna take $6.75 worth of these Twinkies!
He slams a hand onto the counter.
And you're gonna be okay with that!
Okay!
Little Will scurries away.
Pause the tape!
The tape pauses.
Rewind!
The tape rewinds when it reaches the part where Little Will has his hands on the counter.
Pause. Zoom in on his hand.
It zooms in on his hand. A knuckle tattoo of a horse is clearly visible, as well as clearly drawn on with marker.
That tattoo! That's our identifier!
The robber really had a horse knuckle tattoo in real life. Now that's a badass motherfucker.
Trudy, break the fourth wall selectively. We're on a roll here.
Of course, I'm sorry to continue.
What kind of person has a horse knuckle tattoo? More importantly, where would a person with a horse knuckle tattoo spend their time?
What are they doing?
Let them work their PR magic.
I think I got it.
Golly, Mio, my, I think I do too.
Me also as well.
A hipster drug dealer who frequents artisanal gastropubs.
It didn't actually happen exactly like that. It took a lot more time, more clues, more gluing pictures to the wall and connecting them with red yarn. But this is, well, almost Hollywood, and we gotta keep it snappy. See, darling, that's how you break a fourth wall, with little tidbits about storytelling process.
I'm gonna nail it in the next scene, you'll see.
I believe you so hard. Now, to the gastropub!
Actually, I'm not feeling so good. I was wondering if we could take a break.
No!
You mean an intermission? But we're not even done with the first act!
And we're all having so much fun, right?
Everyone ignores her.
Oh, I know, but you're the boss, and you can make the rules.
That's true. I am.
And you're changing theater already with this play.
This is the greatest piece of theater ever made.
You deserve to take a rest. We all do, from the brilliant.
It is so tiring.
I do have a whole chunk of cheese in the mini fridge I've been meaning to eat.
Great farmer favorite.
I don't want to stop acting. Let's keep going.
I declare an intermission for the cast. You all have to stay in your seats, because we don't want any stragglers when we get started again.
He grabs Trudy's hand.
Let's go fantasize about a Tony Award.
Dope! It worked!
Little Will runs off stage. Derek takes off the mannequin and sets her on stage. He follows Little Will.
Stage to myself, huh? It's a pretty tasty situation, I gotta say.
She gives one of her cleaning bottles a little sexy spritz.
Who wants to hear about my childhood trauma, huh? I lost my place. Fuck.
Hey, I was doing the thing.
Okay. Skip bop boop beep. Skip bop boop dang. My parents got divorced and it was never the same.
Hey, I was doing a thing though!
Let's go back to the Toilet Kingdom and again, I guess.
There's still an exit, but we can't see. Either at the end of the mezzanine or up on the light platform. Derek enters.
What's up, little bitch? How's it going?
Dude, please do not make fun of me right now. I have like 5 minutes to myself.
Gonna?
What are you doing here?
Derek burps.
Just standing, bro.
Okay.
Little Will turns back in, looking at nothing. Derek takes a seat next to him.
Parents are weird. Dicks to you.
I know that too.
It makes me uncomfortable.
What the fuck are you talking about? You're a bigger dick to me.
But that's how it's supposed to be. Parents aren't supposed to do that. Track and field guys like me are supposed to do that.
So you admit that you're the worst?
Why don't you just tell them to fuck off?
They don't mean it. They just want me to be better.
How? You're a parent's dream. You don't bring flat Dr. Pepper mixed with vodka to school.
I suck. Like, that's common knowledge. I don't mind them wanting me to be less, like this.
Do you want to go to a party tonight?
I already asked my dad if I could go to Jason's, and he said no.
Not fucking Jason's party. A real party with a keg and cheerleaders.
Both? In the same room? How does that even happen?
Let's go.
Now?
Yeah, now.
But intermission is almost over.
So what?
But Dad will be pissed.
Who gives a shit?
But Mom will be disappointed.
Everyone is disappointed all the time.
Wow. That's heavy and accurate. Are you actually smart?
I'm gonna help you stick it to your old man.
I don't know if I want to do that.
Shut up. We're going now. But first, shotgun this beer.
Derek pulls out a beer out of his pocket somehow and stabs it with a pocket knife. He holds it up to Lowell's face.
I'm shotgunning a beer.
Shotgun a beer.
From the darkness comes sexy noises.
Wowee Sowie. You've been driving me crazy all night. Drive me harder, you hot banshee.
Well, where did you go, honey? I microwaved the cheese for the sensual fondue. Why is it so dark? Are you over here? Will!
Trudy! It's not what it looks like!
I knew it! I knew you were gonna fuck the mysterious woman!
She means nothing to me! She's just some mannequin from Overstock.com!
And that's supposed to make me feel better?
Please, Trudy, I wasn't cheating on you.
I don't think so, mister. You don't get to decide that. I do.
But she isn't real.
Did you get all up in that mannequin vajay?
Now, hey. I wouldn't call it a vajay. I would call it a hole I made with a butter knife.
That's cheating. Don't you see? If she were real, you probably would have fucked her anyways.
Trudy exits. Will grabs his skull.
Oh, so much stress. My hair plugs are on fire! I have to make it right and rid myself of the plug pain!
Will exits, following Trudy. End of Act One.
Hello! Hello, Lady Janitor entering. Did I miss anything?
Hi. Just kidding, I don't care.
Hello.
Hi. It was. Like, this is my entrance place. Can you, like. Fuck it. I'm trying to act, okay? Alright, well, I'm sure it's the same old Act One. They've been doing for 4 nights. They solved the mystery. Everything is fine. It's good. Normally I'd be sad that I missed it, but tonight was a good haul for me, toilet treasure wise. You know, like toilet treasures? Yeah. Yeah, you know, this guy! Okay. You know, like things that you find in the bathroom floor that you want to keep. And since you guys have been a great audience, I wanted to give you guys some toilet treasures. This one's for the lady in front. Hey. You've been a great cook. I want you to know that your beard is amazing. And that's for a special occasion, okay? Don't use it too fast. And hey, if you need help using it, don't ask me, because I don't want to tell you.
Right? You'll get there.
I'm just kidding.
Oh, that's for me. This is for you. All right.
Hey, man, buy yourself something nice with that beard. Wait, no, that's how I pay for my. I really like ramen and I kind of have a problem with it. What? What? What?
Like I'm a little in love with you, but it's not like that. It's like
when your mailman hands you a package. Like, my dick doesn't get hard for you, but my heart does. Like, my heart is just throbbing for your friendship, Jeffy.
You have one beer.
Is this what male friendship looks like? I'm generally asking because, you know, skibbity-boop-bop-beep, the only friend I've ever had is a broom with a hat. And it's not a typical friendship, it's more of like a friends with benefits. You know what I'm saying.
That's what I'm talking about! Priscilla gets the party lifestyle! Now let's go, buddy! What's
up? Mom, just saw it, Jim Shonobi took off. We can go in a few minutes. Just chill, man.
I wanna rage now. What the party spirit has laid an egg inside of me that is now about to hatch.
Maybe I can sneak you guys out through the vents in the janitor's closet. That's typically where I store my pounds of cashews.
I store cashews.
I like to buy in bulk. Also have some squirrel DNA on the ground.
Tight! I want squirrel DNA and a tattoo. Derek, give me a tattoo on my neck that says Yoplait.
I'm not tattooing a yogurt brand on your neck.
But it's the thing I love most in the world. My digestion is so regular.
A party? Is that where you're taking him, Derek?
Trudy enters.
Oh, damn, you got caught.
I wasn't conspiring to help him, Trudy. I'm on your side, because you're the mom.
Damn shit straight I am. Tell me about this party, Derek.
No, I just wanted to take a lifting break. You know, just using your son like a human weight. That's why I'm holding him.
Derek acts little up and down. Little Will looks like he's going to puke every time Derek pushes him up.
Nice try, Derek, but I'm not as dumb as the results of my DNA might suggest. I know you can only replace an inanimate object with a human being in three scenarios. When you need food, a coffee table, or a scarf. Not wait.
I have questions about all of those, but mostly the scarf.
On cold nights, Will sometimes wraps his whole body around my neck like a python for warmth.
Isn't that what your parents do?
No. It's a known fact that John Malkovich doesn't produce any body heat.
That's beside the point. I know you are lying. Let me smell his breath. I have to find out if you smell like your dad when he's watching Tiny House Nation.
I have been Cosmopolitan's and angrily live tweeting.
You've been drinking.
I have not.
Oh, so you weren't pre-gaming before the party? Yeah, that's right, dweebs. I know the slang.
She's onto us.
We'll never escape.
We're gonna have to bring the party here, little bitch. Quick, drink the beer in my front pocket.
How do you so many beers hidden on the purse?
There's no time to explain. Chomp, little bitch, chomp.
No.
You don't understand, Miss Milford. I have to make little bitch cool tonight.
You don't have to make me cool tonight only, doopity nerd. You'll see me at school tomorrow. Right? Like, normally, when we pass each other after second period and you look at me like I'm a Mountain Dew can you want to crush with your head, you'll wave instead tomorrow, right? And, like, give me wisdom and stuff, like how to throw a football or cyberbully someone. You'll wait for me tomorrow, right?
Derek, don't you see you're just making things worse for when the show's over? Just give him to me.
No!
Derek, don't worry. I'm a cool mom. I wear Uggs. I'm just gonna help them sober up. I was an Ira Glass book tour groupie, so this ain't my first opium.
That is pretty cool.
Yeah, that's right, Derek. Trust me with your drunk friend. I won't lecture him at all. I swear not to ask any questions like, do you want to grow up to be like your Aunt Marge, the one who goes on quarters and sleeps in a cave made of vintage Barbie dolls and vodka bottles?
No.
Derek, she's lying. She's definitely going to compare me to Aunt Marge. This all happened before when my cousin let me have some jazz kale last Thanksgiving.
That's not true, Derek. I've always been super cool with pot. I love to spark up doobies and hack some sack with the munchies every night before watching sex films.
Oh, that's cool too!
You said if I ever wanted to smoke pot, I should just go see high school improv because it kills just as many brain cells.
Stop joking around. Derek, it's time for you to give it to me.
But he doesn't want to.
Don't string my
pass that along.
We're not trying to get hot and squashy, if that's what you're saying.
You know exactly what I'm talking about.
Fine.
Victory!
Derek!
The door is
Did someone say they are missing a patriarch? Someone missing a patriarch? God. My new friends taught me how to download an app that makes me enter a room like a rapper.
I don't want to see you right now. Well,
it can't be.
Ah, good evening, my brothers. What are you doing here?
You weren't at practice today, again.
We came to see if the rumors were true.
And how disappointed we are to find this.
This is low, Derek. You were once king of the track,
prime minister of the field,
leader of the track and field boys.
Hoorah!
We find you here, doing theater with little bitch's family? You ruined your cred, Derek! You ruined it!
And our crew was so tight. Now the battle's all off within the boys. Just look what you've done to ice.
I weep every time I go into a deep mud!
I just need extra credit for a theater class!
No, I'll give you some extra credit. Here's extra, and here's credit.
Right.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The track and field guys don't need extra credit because we do the coolest sport in school.
Yes, I followed.
And I pointed to my thighs because they're a symbol of track and field, because no other athletic program could make anyone's legs look so righteous.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yo,
yeah, good job,
bro.
No excuses, Derek. No excuses.
Who are these sock puppets?
It's my track and field clique, also known as my new family. I found them running in place outside.
Yeah, but we couldn't figure out how to get inside, so we're just trying to keep warm.
Yeah, God is doing
this. God is doing this.
Why is he being friendly with a new family, Mom? Are you guys fighting?
This is my new favorite son, Ice.
What's up? I'm Ice, 100 meter dash, undefeated blue ribbon holder for the past 2 seasons. Always keep goldfish in my pocket for energy.
Ice.